always a little bit neglected when we talk about hub metrics. It has been part of hub metrics from the beginning, which is other research outputs, or outputs, if you will. And we have had a special session on this topic in 1 a.m. and 2 a.m. and a continuous tradition, if you will. And we have 4 presenters in the next hour. One presentation about research data, and very interesting, 3 presentations about software. So that's clearly an emerging topic, so you're probably all aware of that. We are currently running about 25 minutes late in our program. The last session will probably be a little bit shorter than expected, because not everybody could come to Bucharest, so that we should finish shortly after 5:30, I suppose, just in time for reception and post-interview. So if you stay with us for another 2 hours, then the drinks will be more pleasurable. The first presentation is by Nicolas Robinson Garcia. And
and try to understand what is the information they provide to us and see the
this type of analysis are feasible currently. So this is just to give you an idea of the fields that I use that we retrieve from data sites the fields that we have so that we can analyze each of them and try to find some kind of link between geographical distribution and origin of the data and the data set themselves. This is the citation recommendation form that they provide currently. So what we did is that this is a quick overview about what is contained in data site right now. So as you can see, data is a very big word, very heterogeneous in forms, and we have all kinds of data there. Of course, but only I think more than 40% of it is actually data sets. Also, we're trying to data collection, which we data taking is called data studies. So collections of data sets, but then also we have lots of publications, images, etc. So so the concept of data is much bigger than it can be treated as a homogeneous thing. And if we go, what we've done so far is try to go to those mandatory fields and try to find if we can link them with countries. And the first one I'm going to show you here is the results which are really consistent in this year, which have to do with the publisher field. Try to understand what is a publisher when we're talking about data and if it has any kind of link with where the data was produced. And what we find is that 20% of the records in the database actually do not report the publisher, which is supposed to be a mandatory field. So we already find some problems with it. There's also problems with languages, so there are many repositories who don't know what they are because of languages and transliteration from different alphabets. But even so, we can roughly give an idea of the type of publishers that I explained in the data site. So we've been working on developing a kind of typology of publisher to try to understand what do we mean by publisher actually. We find that, of course, most of them are unassigned because it's the data is very basic right now. But we see that around 30% of the data is actually comes from thematic repositories, we have institutional repositories, research networks, and associations, etc. We also have lots of publishers, and publishers are mainly journals as well, etc. And even we have private data producers, or even authors, which are named as the publisher of the data. So the concept of publisher is also quite tricky in this area. And just to give you a rough idea, because the idea here was to show something related to citations and metrics. Here we show the match of the DOIs which are mentioned in Web of Science, and that's cited from Web of Science to data site, and also from metric.com. As you can see, we have almost none, roughly less than 1% for both types of metrics. And also, if we even go deeper and try to see which are the documents which are actually cited, we see that, for instance, the most cited data set is actually a paper. So we see that, again, we have to deal with this kind of source and try to distinguish between what is actually data set, what is actually what we're trying to look at. And most of the data set is actually a fossil. So again, we have the same issue. So based on this publisher's information, we try to at least have some kind of sense of where the data infrastructure is more developed. And this is a mapping of the number of records assigned to each country, depending on the publisher. We find that the UK is the one which has more data sets that come from a provider, from a publisher, which is going to have in Germany, Switzerland, etc. Also, this can be quite biased by the origin of data science, which is social media made by German institutions, of course, so we may be biased there. And if we go into the type of publishers that we see there, we see different profiles of different countries. So this is just the top five. And we can see that most of the repositories in the UK, about half of them are actually thematic repositories. So we will find that data sets from different countries, not only from the UK. But in the case of Switzerland, it's institutional repositories, the ones which are more developed. So from a metric perspective, what we find is two types of problems from a perspective of technical issues, which actually with the use of the tool and of the idea of sharing data and producing data, and also there are conceptual limitations which have to do with this way of trying to force the citation, theory, and publication way of working into another environment which does not necessarily comply to it. Okay, so when we talk about technical issues, just as an example, we find that there is an heterogeneity of sources, so there is a problem trying to find what is actually scientific data, what I'm talking about, what I'm talking about data. There is a lack of basic data for us in nutrition, because we need applications always, so that is something that is lacking, and we'd like to find ways of trying to actually build it. And of course, there's a lack of standard localization in the sense that the way that, for instance, the name of creators is presented, varies a lot, it's not presented in a standard format, like for instance in web science. From a conceptual point of view, we have problems. There's a problem between the production patterns of publications and data. We have to understand what our data is produced. If we can somehow compare data producers with other classical producers, something like that. And of course, we have to rethink about the concept of citation. The citation, citing a data set means actually the same in this environment. As in publishing articles. So what is the meaning for the motivation for the researcher to actually cite data? And of course, there's also conceptual heterogeneity. So just looking at the publisher information, we already see that there are different conceptions of what an actual publisher is, who is the actual publisher of the data set. Some examples of these problems is, for instance, when we look at the publication order and the data use distribution. If we look at the world of science and we look for the most productive researcher, there's actually several ones, because it's not the same degrading fact that it has less than 6,000 publications. Then if we do the same with data side, we find that actually this guy about to exist, Joseph Gunn, has at least half a million data sets produced. So there are huge differences in production. And if we go to see who this guy is, we actually see that he does not do any training on his website about this aspect of his. So he doesn't really acknowledge the production of data as one of the merits that he has. Okay? So it's also interesting to see how the researchers perceive this production of knowledge of data as something important to know. As an example of the heterogeneity of publishing information, we find lots of references to articles. So probably supplementary material or actual papers which are deposited. We find QI numbers, we find the copyright statements, and that one is just one, so this is not very common, but it was quite surprising to find hashtag as a publisher. It actually comes from a paper, a drawing which is uploaded in research paper, so it's not even a paper. And well, that's it.
So any question for you?
Also, we can somehow match all those we created here. No.